Good morning. How's everybody this morning? Good, I'm a little taller, so I apologize. So on behalf of our county executive, Al Brooks Patterson, I'm happy to be here with you this morning and be part of the event here for the Oakland Chamber Network. What you see standing before you is the only representative from the only county in this region that is actually invested in regional initiatives. No matter what has been said over the last 2 days, our county executive is a champion of regional initiatives. It's been a rough 2 days. And there was a lot of comments that had been made. And we had a reporter who chose to take 20-year-old quotes instead of the hours that we had spent with her talking about all the regional initiatives and the exciting things that we're doing being part of this region and as part of Oakland County. I can't tell you how much we've invested. We've invested in the largest law enforcement data consortium in the entire nation, our Clemens Initiative. It's in 150 public safety agencies in 6 different counties, serving millions of people. We've invested in the Detroit Zoo. We've invested in numerous other programs. Cobble Hall and the Cobble Convention Center wouldn't have happened if Al Brooks Patterson hadn't stuck to his guns and asked for the financials. All we wanted to see were the financial numbers. And today you'll read in the paper about the Detroit Water and Sewer Department, and they'll talk about how they want us to make a multi-million dollar deal without seeing any financial forecasts or capital improvement forecasts. They want us to just go ahead and sign. We're not going to do that. Okay? We're fiduciaries. We have a fiduciary responsibility for the dollars that are invested in this county and the dollars that all of you are bringing in through jobs, taxes, you name it, all kinds of revenues. We're there to work for you. So I'm here to let you know this morning, first thing, and let's just nail it right now, that this county executive believes in Oakland County. He's believed in this region for a very long time. And if they want to go ahead and smear him with quotes and do different things to impact him, it's not going to matter in the long run because we are financially sound. We have the most incredible chamber network in the entire nation. We have the best businesses in the entire nation. The business community here is second to none. And we're going to be successful as Oakland County in the long term. So I wanted you all to know that first thing this morning. All right, so let's talk about what's going on in Oakland County, because it is very important for all of you who are out there really marketing this region and marketing this county to bring more and more businesses. I can't tell you all the people that I've enjoyed being part of ribbon cuttings with. I think the last year was like crazy, wasn't it? I mean, we were doing ribbon cuttings every other month. That's awesome, right? That's incredible that we have that many new businesses opening up. It's creating jobs. Big, small, medium, doesn't matter what size they are, we're creating jobs. And it's a wonderful thing. And government, by the way, doesn't create jobs. Government, the responsibility of government is to provide an environment where jobs flourish and businesses flourish. And that's what we're trying to do as a county. And there's several ways that we're doing that. First, we're financially sound. I can let you know that we've retained our AAA bond rating in the most difficult economic times, at least in my lifetime. We have a bankruptcy to our south. We have the city of Flint, who's under financial receivership. We had the city of Pontiac that was in had a financial manager in place. We had all this happening, yet we were able to maintain our AAA bond rating from Moody's and Standard & Poor's. As a matter of fact, Standard & Poor's said if they could, they would award Oakland County a platinum rating. They said they don't have a high enough rating for what we're able to accomplish here in Oakland County. And by the way, that's all in due part to the partnership we have with our citizens, the partnership we have with our businesses, and the partnership that we have with all of you. We are a financially sound county. We have a balanced budget for 2014, 15, and 16. Our forecasts show that our budget will be balanced for 2017 and 2018. Simple philosophy. Ready? Don't spend more than you have. Matter of fact, spend a little less than you have so you can prepare for those tough financial times that you'll run into. We started restructuring government back in 1993 when Brooks came into office. He started restructuring government back then. Our latest restructuring started taking place in 2003. We saw this coming. We didn't know to the extent that it was going to happen, but we saw our revenue stream start to slow down. So we started restructuring county government. We started not hiring people. We put a hiring freeze in place. And we've had a hiring freeze in place for 5 years. And we have a budget task force, and Brooks created the budget task force in the mid-2000s, where the five deputy county executives, which I'm one of, we sit there and we make all the decisions in regard to filling positions or spending money at the county. All those decisions have to come and get approved. And he even says that he let it get out of control because we took his car away. Says, see what happens? You empower five people to do things and they take your car away. We don't have county cars. Now, we do have them for certain functions of government, but not in the executive staff. And the reason why is because you have to lead by example. We took a 4% pay reduction as employees, and we all took that in the administration as well. We took benefit changes. Why did we do all that? We needed to survive through the tough times, and we needed to still be innovative and do good things for the people of this county so that when we came out of the tough times, we would be even more successful. And I think all of you are starting to see that happen in our economy. Now, a couple of economic development issues that I think are worth touching on, because this has been a long-standing effort under the county executive. He always talks about, I want to create, this is his words now, that he would like to create initiatives that last well beyond his terms in office. He wants initiatives that we can plant the seeds and then watch them grow. So let's talk about a few of those. Automation Alley. In the late 1990s, he was talking to, the 98-99 timeframe, he was talking to the business community, and he had started his business roundtable in 1993 and been getting advice from the business community, and over 85% of all of the advice that's been provided to him has been operationalized in county government. But in the late 90s, the business community said, we don't have a voice. We don't have a voice. So with 43 companies, inside Oakland County, he started Automation Alley. And the goal of Automation Alley was to change the reputation of Southeast Michigan and really Oakland County from the Rust Belt to the Tech Belt, right? Rust to Tech. We have these knowledge-based, we wanted to be in this knowledge-based economy, knowing full well that many of our eggs were all in the automotive basket. So we started Automation Alley. Today, Automation Alley spans the majority of the counties in Southeast Michigan. It now has an office in the city of Detroit, and it has over 1,000 companies as members. Ken Rogers, deputy county executive for the county, is also the executive director for Automation Alley, and he's made it his passion and his drive to operationalize this idea that started in the late 90s with a handful of companies inside Oakland County to make it a regional initiative. And by the way, Oakland County has been investing in Automation Alley all this time. So the next time someone says we're not regional, example one, Automation Alley. The second thing that was happening is in the early 2000s too, we started to see our economy shift. And we saw the struggle that was starting to take place when you have one major industry that manages and really runs the entire economy. So Brooks asked his economic development folks, and it was 2003-2004 timeframe, to go out and look for the companies of the new economy and start talking about what do we need to do to attract those companies. So they went out and did their research. They picked the top 10 sectors of the new economy: life sciences, the financial industry, information technology, nanoscience, biotech, all those things. And they went and found the top 10 companies in each of those sectors. And here's the scary part. 60% of all of those companies had no presence in the United States of America. So the top 10 companies in the top 10 sectors of the new economy, 60% of them had no presence in the United States. None. That's alarming. So if we're going to go ahead and tackle that from an economic perspective, the goal is to get those companies and bring them here to Oakland County. So we've had some successes, first set of successes. The investment in Oakland County since the beginning of what Brooks calls his Emerging Sectors Program has been $2.6 billion since 2004. It has created 30,000 new jobs and helped us retain more than 14,000 jobs. Now, why is that important? Actually, I have to give you a funny anecdote. In 2012, when Mr. Patterson was running for reelection, and you remember, he had just come off of his horrific car accident, and people were accusing him of not having done anything for Oakland County. And I was standing at a podium very similar to this, speaking on his behalf, and I talked about, at the time, was 20-some thousand jobs. And the person told me, that's just ridiculous. We lost 60,000 jobs in this county in 2009, and you're celebrating gaining 20,000 jobs. And I laughed. I said, really? We should just not create new jobs? Should we just stop the economy and take our lumps and live with the fact that we lost 60,000 jobs? I'll take 20,000, I'll take 30,000 new jobs. You know why? Because with those jobs, people buy homes, they buy goods, they support local businesses. I'll take them however they come, whether it's 10 jobs, 20 jobs, 30 jobs, 100 jobs, it doesn't matter. Everything starts with a job. If we want this economy to flourish, we have to make it so that people can invest in it. And that's done through the business community. We understand that. And they employ people. We understand that. And by the way, those people pay taxes. And that's what helps fund government services. So as an economic development strategy, it's about the jobs. And our goal is to go find those jobs wherever they are and to bring those companies here to Oakland County to create those kinds of jobs. That's what we're doing. And we're going to continue to do that. Our largest sector right now is information technology, but at one time it was healthcare. You know, the largest employer in Oakland County is no longer General Motors. It's Beaumont Hospitals. They're the largest employer in the county. I think it's somewhere around 14,000 jobs in the healthcare area. And when we did a study, we found that over 90,000 people were employed in healthcare in the county. So we started looking at what do we need to do to foster that? What do we need to do to grow that sector of our business? So we created a program called Medical Main Street. And the Medical Main Street program brought all of the major hospitals together, brought the medical device companies together, and all the different healthcare providers, put them together in one room and said, hey, we need to rebrand Oakland County as a destination for healthcare. Has anyone ever heard of medical tourism? Have you heard that term? I think that I was reading something the other day that you can get a surgery in Costa Rica and you can bring your whole family and make a vacation out of it. All right, one major flaw. This is just me speaking out loud. I don't know if I want to get my surgery in Costa Rica. I'd rather get it here where we have the top doctors and the top healthcare providers in the nation right here in Southeast Michigan. And there's a reason why people go off and go to the Mayo Clinic. There's a reason why people go do those things. Is that's because of the reputation and what people said, they get great care. We have people coming from all over the world to Southeast Michigan to get their health care, and we need to promote that. And I can let you know this morning that all of the major hospitals are working together. All of the medical device companies are working together. And what they're doing is they're finding ways to rebrand. Two good examples. In 2012 and 2013, we had what we call the Innovention Conference. The Innovention Conference. The first year, we weren't sure what was going to happen. We had capacity for about 300 or so, and we were going to have all these speakers talk about the healthcare industry and all the great things, and we oversold it. Not only did we oversell it, we live web streamed it to all over the world, and people picked it up. Second year, we had the Innovation Conference. We weren't worried about selling it out. We were worried about if we had enough room. So we went to a larger venue even, we put it all together, and we filled the room again, and then again live streamed it. Healthcare is a growing industry. Look at what's going on at Oakland University with the William Beaumont School of Medicine. In the first year, I think it was some crazy number, we had 3,000 applicants that went for 50 slots in the medical school. This is changing the landscape. What we're doing is we're attracting the best and the brightest to Oakland County, and then there's studies out there that say when they graduate, they don't go very far from where they got their degree. Wouldn't that be nice to bring all these wonderful doctors in for education and then have them available to provide health care to the citizens of Oakland County, the 1.2 million people in Oakland County that need health care services? So we're excited about Medical Main Street, and we're excited about our Emerging Sectors Program. Why? Because it's creating jobs. again, economic development is the root of economic development is to get people jobs and create the business community so that they can help fund the services that we need to provide. Now, you know, when a lot of people talk about, you know, why should I pay taxes? My start of my career in Oakland County in 1988 is I was in the equalization division. Anybody know what that is? That's the property tax division. So I was an assessor. And I went out and I assessed homes and businesses for property tax purposes. I can say, honestly, I didn't get too many Christmas cards. There weren't people saying that thank you for my fair and equitable assessment, but it was a necessary function. People want police on the streets. They want fire departments. They want city services that they need to go ahead and provide for the quality, the health, the safety, and the welfare of the people. They need that. And there has to be a way to fund it. The property tax system has been that way for many years. It's not a popular thing, and no one likes paying their taxes, but you know what? It's what makes the world go round for those services. Look at what was happening in the city of Pontiac. At one time, they had 170 sworn police officers. They went down to about 30 police officers to patrol the entire city of Pontiac on a 24/7 basis. You can't do that. The sheriff's office is in there, immediately boosted the officer count, and you can drive down those streets, and the sheriff's deputies have told me this, they drive down the streets and the people are excited that they're there. Why? Because the root of a community, too, is to have safe streets. Another foundational aspect is good schools. And we strive here in Oakland County, and I think we have some of the best public schools anywhere in the country right here in Oakland County. And I hope someone's taping that. My wife's a public school teacher. And I could use the points right about now. But again, remember, it's about the economy and it's about those jobs. A couple other things that we've done over this tough time is we've been investing in innovation. I am the CIO for the county as well, and we have a government cloud we call the G2G Cloud Solutions. We are now providing government technology services to 51 different public sector entities inside and outside Oakland County. Why are we doing that? It's because the people need those services, and if we can lower the cost of those technologies for the medium to small size governments to use them, they can consume them and then they can supply those services to their citizens. It's about governments helping other governments. That's pretty innovative, and that was all created during the most devastating economic situation we've been in many, many, many years. Why? Because you have to innovate in tough economic times. You have to change the way you do business. You have to change the way you provide services. You have to do all those things if you're going to be able to be better at what you do and provide quality services. That's what we strive to do at Oakland County, and we are being innovative. So as a county, we're doing some pretty good stuff.